Right. Namaste everyone. Thanks for joining Hindi University. This is Ashutosh. As you know, we meet every Sunday at 10 a.m. US Eastern to discuss a new topic in Hindi. In this class, I decided to pick a grammar-related topic. We use it very frequently on a day-to-day conversation without knowing it. In Hindi, it's called Nipat. Nipat. So the way you write it is na with e, pa with a, and then ta. I'm sure there are some, you know, similar analogy you can draw of Nipat with other languages as well. The closest English word that I could find here was emphasis. Emphasis. So, you know, the definition of, you know, this particular topic, Nipat, is, and we'll be covering Nipat in, you know, two classes, in this class as well as in the next class. There are about 8 or 9 types of Nipat, okay? You know, these are basically helping words. And you will see them, like there are 7 or 8 type of different helping words, right? These are helping words which provide variety to a sentence. Okay. We've discussed some of them before, such as to, right? I mean, remember, if you remember some of the keywords, to, and then he, right? Now we'll discuss all of them a little bit more systematically in their different divisions. Most of the Nipat, they don't change based on the, you know, they don't depend on the adjectives or the, you know, or the noun or the pronoun or basically the number. You know, basically what I'm trying to say, there is no oblique case. They're not unaffected by that, right? If you remember, like, you know, most of the things, they change in Hindi because of the inflection, like ladka become, you know, ladke in the plural, right? And then, you know, if you're using it with a postposition, ladke becomes ladko. But Nipat, you know, all the keywords, they do not change. Whether you have a postposition ahead of them, whether you have like a plural, they remain constant. Okay, so they maintain their basically form. Okay. So that's basically the overview of, like, you know, the definition of Nipat. Now we'll go into the different types of Nipat. So the first form of Nipat that I have is affirmative or positive. Affirmative or the positive. Positive form of Nipat. And I'm sure these are very common, and you probably have seen them, you know, using yourself, right? Very simple, like, you know, you've seen words like ha. Huh? You've seen words like G. Okay. You've seen words like G, huh, as well. G, huh? And then similarly, word like hum. All of them are basically affirmative or positive form of Nipat. They're used to kind of show your affirmation to a particular situation, right? You don't have to use the entire sentence after ha. For example, if you're asking me a question and I'm agreeing to it, I can simply say ha. If I want to give you extra respect or more respect, if I'm talking to someone elder, I can say ji ha, right? Sometimes you'll see people say hum as well, hum. Okay, and that's also a positive form of the Nipat. We'll look at some of the examples. Okay. Oftentimes you see that people, you know, use Nipat in the form of, like, you know, basically the way they tilt their head or they give the expression, because that's also a form of giving your affirmation, okay, I'll do it, or something like that, right? So let's look at some of the examples of the affirmative Nipat. So imagine that someone is asking a question. Imagine a scenario when someone is asking you a question, kya aap, will you, let's say, will you come with me? And that's also basically a challenge for you to write down the sentence in Hindi, right? Will you come with me? So, you know, while I'm writing or teaching you Nepal, feel free to write down the Hindi translation of this question as well. you know, to come in this case, like, you know, think of it as like, you know, basically, will you go with me, right? So chalna is to go, right? And it's a future indefinite. So the verb will be, because it's you, chalenge, right? Think, I mean, as always, break it down, right? I mean, so if you were to write simple sentence, you will come or you will go, it would be aap chalenge, right? Aap chalenge. Will you come would be as simple as that, kya aap chalenge, right? So what you did, you took the verb and you change it into the future indefinite form, which we have learned it in the past. So, you know, simply you are saying, aap chalenge is like you will come or you will, like, you know, go in this case. And then kya aap chalenge is like, will you come? Will you come? That's it, right? Now you're saying with me, right? So all you have to do is kya aap, and then you'll put it here. With me is mere saath. Chalenge. Okay, I'll write it down again. So, kya aap mere saath chalenge? So far, you've not seen a nipas, right? I mean, so far, you've not seen any emphasis, emphatical word here. So far, it's just a question like, will you come with me? Kya aap mere saath chalenge? You know, if for those of you, it's this one is difficult, with me is mere saath. You know, with, you can practice it again, with him is uske saath. With us, hamare saath, similarly, I'll give you a quick question, with them, what will be with them? With them would be, right, with them would be for folks who are watching live on YouTube, you can also write down in the comments. Okay, so them, remember, like, you know, with him is uske saath, them is kind of a plural, right? So remember, we learned ve when you're referring to they, but when you're saying with them is like unke saath. So we just took a small detour from our section, but you know, I think still important, right, to learn about with. Okay, so again, if you remember, the situation here is like, if somebody is asking you this question, will you come with me, right? Kya aap mere saath chalenge, right? Now you can use nipat here, you know, emphatical words to show your response, right? First one, as I said, you can use haan, main aapke saath chalunga. And because the subject here is main, you know, the verb here is changes from chalna to chalunga, and that's again a future indefinite, right? Main chalunga, right? Haan, main chalunga, or you can simply say haan. You can also say haan ji or ji haan. Okay, as I said, you can say hoon also. Some people say hoon to show their, like, you know, agreement. Okay, that's use of nipat. Another interesting thing here is that you can use them twice. And that shows your, like, you know, extra, you know, power behind your affirmation, right? So you can say, you can say it twice. And say same thing in English also. Sometimes you say, yes, right? I mean, or like, you know, you become more, you know, you try to give more your power to your agreement that, yes, I'll definitely come with you, right? Or you can also say, haan ji, haan. Like, you know, so again, the scenario could be if a teacher is asking you a question and, you know, you are absolutely sure about it and you don't want to wait for a second, right? Or if you're in a quiz competition and there's a buzzer around, you give some answer and the host is asking you, are you sure? And you are like, yes, I'm definitely sure. So those are the scenarios where you can kind of, like, you know, use them twice. So I hope this is clear, you know, the positive form of NEPA. We'll jump to the negative form now. Some of them you're familiar with, but, you know, what I have later on, you know, the NEPA that I have later on, you know, we have not covered so far in, you know, in the 6 years of videos that, you know, I have prepared. So we'll discuss those as well. The next one is negative form of NEPA. I'm sure you probably already figured out. So I'm going to give you some time to see if you can, you know, predict which one these will be. Okay, very good. Anyone else? Right. Okay, very good, right? So similar to what we've discussed, these can be nahi and you have na, nahi, he. Okay. You can have ji nahi if you want to give respect. Right? Ji nahi. Ji nahi can also be used as a sarcasm, right? I mean, you know, you want to be a little bit more, you want to have some sarcasm behind your response, so that can be used ji nahi. And that you can use just na as well, which is just simply na, or you can use na. All of them are valid negative form of NEPA, and that shows your disagreement with something, right? So imagine a scenario where somebody is asking you a question. Let me erase them. And so somebody is asking you the question, and the question is, did you eat the cake? And I want you to translate it with me, so that way at least, you know, you can practice it. So, you know, as we work on the negative form of the NEPA. Okay, very good. So there's a, you know, interrogative in the, you know, front as well. Try it. And if you have trouble translating the sentence into Hindi, start with very simple, which is the past indefinite, you ate. And then you build on top of it, you ate the cake. And then you can say, did you eat the cake? Very good, right? So basically, somebody is asking you the question, kya aapne cake khaya? And I'm glad some of you were able to, you know, sense it. It was a difficult thing. If you remember the whole thing, you know, it requires a lot of like kind of like a prior knowledge of Hindi, right? I mean, because you have you here, which is aap. Okay, you can tell that eat is a transitive verb, you know, which is used in the past indefinite form, right? So that's why you have to have which subject you used a postposition called ne, right? And after that you have cake, right? Because cake is masculine singular, you know, you were saying to eat is khana, your transitive verb, and in the past indefinite it is changed into khaya, right? So your again your sentence becomes kya aapne cake khaya, right? So thanks so much for, you know, for writing it. Now, you know, you can show your disagreement in several ways, as I said, right? Using nipat. So you can say nahi, as simple as that. You can only say nahi, that's it. Sometimes the pitch of the nahi also kind of shows your disagreement. In a, you don't have to repeat it twice. Your pitch is so high that the person will be like, okay, I got it, right? Or you can say ji nahi, and again the way you are saying ji nahi can either you can be polite, either it can be inferred as you're being polite, or you have a sarcasm, right? Sarcasm in a sense that, you know, imagine a scenario where the person was never being offered the cake, right? And they can use this in a very, you know, the way they're saying it, ji nahi, that means like, you know, they're automatically coming across as if like, you know, they are being upset that they were never offered the cake, yet they were asked the question that did you eat the cake, right? And you can also say na. Na or na. To show your disagreement, right? Or if you want to write the entire sentence, you can say maine maine na khaya, maine na khaya, or you can say maine nahi khaya. Or you can use it ji nahi before the sentence, ji nahi, and then you can follow with the rest of the sentence, ji nahi, maine nahi khaya. All of them are exactly same. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. I hope this gave you a little bit more variety than just learning about nahi, right? Because so far, you know, in the past, you know, we have not looked at it, you know, in a more detailed manner. We have only used nahi, just say nahi, to show your disagreement. So let's see if you have any questions. In the meantime, you know, folks who are watching live on YouTube, you know, you can also ask your question. Okay, bilkul nahi. You know, that's interesting because, you know, that is also another nipat, right? I mean, you can say bilkul nahi, absolutely not, and that's also correct, right? So it's bilkul. Now, going back to that, you know, bilkul can be used, you know, to show your affirmation as well. So if you go back to our earlier example, kya aap chalenge, or kya aap mere saath chalenge, you can say bilkul, absolutely, right? So that's also another nipat. You know, I can write down the meaning of bilkul. Bilkul is absolutely. Okay, so now, you know, we'll move to the next one, which should take a lot of time because we have not covered it in the past. Okay, most of you have heard of it in Hindi sentences, you know, so it's not going to be probably new to you in terms of, you know, hearing it, but in terms of like going over it, I think I'm doing it for the first time. So the next one is prohibitive. Prohibitive form of nipat. Okay, this one is mat. Don't read it as mat, it's mat, right? It's ma, and then the. Okay, there's no way to write it in English because, you know, we the talu thing that, you know, we don't have it in English, right? So it's ma ta. So the closest one would be ma and then th, ta, mat. Okay, if you've heard of it, you know, feel free to write down a sentence in it to show, you know, your knowledge on this particular keyword. If not, we'll learn it, you know, how to use it and then how to use it in the sense of, like, you know, Nipat. Okay, so let's start with, give me any word. Write down any word that you are familiar with. Okay, you can use it or, you know, comment section to write down any word. Okay, keep them coming. Don't think twice, just write down the word you are familiar with in the group chat, or, you know, have it in your, okay, airport mat khana. The verb here is khana. Any other verb you can think of? Okay, to smoke. Okay, matra. Okay, to smoke. Okay, just write down the word. Don't think, you guys are like way ahead of me. Just like think about the verb, right? Verb is like to eat, to drink, to run, to fly, to cook. Think of it in that form. To speak, you know, to learn, to fight. Okay, so let's take a simple verb, right? I mean, to fight. Anyone? What's the word in Hindi for to fight? Okay, very good, right? To fight is ladna. Ladna. Okay, and the way you say it, like, you know, ladna, ladna, right? Now, when you're saying to someone, like, you know, don't fight, right? There are several ways you can say it, right? So, you have mat. Either you can say in the most simple form, you can say mat ladna. As it is, you can use it as it is, the word mat ladna, right? The second one is mat ladiye, and you can see that what we have done is we have removed na and we put ie, mat ladiye. Okay, I'll go over each of them, what is the difference in each of them. The third one is mat lado. Right, mat lado is what you've done is like you remove na and you put o here, sound of o, mat lado. And the last one you have it is mat lad, lad. Don't treat it as lag, it's lad. Okay, basically you remove na altogether. Now they can be used, you know, I mean, all of them mean the same thing, but, you know, what is the difference, right? I mean, mat ladna is a very simple form. You're being very direct to your colleague, or, you know, you're telling someone do not fight when you go there or when something like this happens. Mat ladiye is like you're being very polite and respectful. Mat ladiye, right? It can also be very generic, that, you know, please mat ladiye, like, you know. So that in that case, it's like, you know, you're being very respectful. Pay attention to it, because I'm gonna ask you to take another word and write down all the different forms of how you will use it with mat. Okay, next one with is like mat lado. So basically this is kind of a command. You're kind of giving a command or an order, mat lado. Right? Same thing like, same thing like, that you said to smoke, right? Now, if a parent is telling their kid, like, smoke mat karo, right? So karma becomes karo there. Right? So that's kind of a command and order, And then this one is like, if you're talking to some, like, again, this one is matlab is kind of, again, an instruction where you are being very direct to your subordinate in this case, and you're saying, matlab, don't do this thing. Right? So again, this is kind of an order. And this one is like, order in the sense like, lado still shows some respect to the person you're talking to. But mat lado is like very direct, don't do it, otherwise there will be consequences kind of a thing. Right? So let's take another example, and I want you to pick or give me another word, so that way we can go over it one more time with another verb. Okay, chinta karna. Okay, so chinta karna, let's let to that. It's an interesting one. So I'll remove it. What is the meaning of, chinta karna in English? Okay, to worry is चिंता करना. चिंता इज नाउन, बट आफ्टर पुटिंग करना यू मेड इट अ वर्ब, राइट? चिंता करना. फॉर फोक्स हु ज्वाइन अ लिटिल लेट, बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग ओवर द न्यू टाइप ऑफ न्यू ग्रामर थिंग, टॉपिक कॉल्ड निपात, विच आर की वर्ड दैट गिव्स वैरायटी टू द सेंटेंस. वी लर्न द affirmative form of nipat, negative form of nipat, but now this is a prohibitive form where you're giving, prohibiting someone to do something, and the word for that is mat, right? And now I want you to use all the four forms basically on this sentence. You can write down the entire sentence, chinta. So, how do you use all the four forms of, prohibitive form using mat on this word? Okay. So the first one is very simple, straightforward. This one is used before, I mean, again, you can use it, the interesting thing about this particular nipat is you can use it before the verb or after the verb. There is no difference in it, right? So basically, so first thing is like you have chinta mat karna. So you use it before the verb. Right, this is the verb and you use chinta mat karna. Okay, so basically a parent can tell the kids like, don't worry about us, like when you this and this happens when you go there to study, chinta mat karna. As I said, it can be used after the verb as well, and the meaning remains the same. So you can say chinta karna mat. So that's the interesting thing about nipat, that they can, you can put them, before the, in this particular one, you can put before the verb or after the verb, right? So that's the simplest form, chinta mat karna. Now, the second one is, as some of you already pointed out, again, like, chinta mat kariye. You're giving respect to someone and you're being polite, and that's why karna becomes kariye. The third one is chinta mat karo. Some respect is still there. And the fourth one is kind of like a direct command or like an order, or like, telling someone very firmly, chinta mat kar. I remember as a teenager, I used to worry a lot, right? I mean, in terms of my marks, right? I mean, if I gave some examination, like final exam, and I felt that, I made some mistakes in the question paper, and I'll worry about it, that okay, my marks will be not as good as I'm expecting, and my father will be okay, chinta mat karo, or chinta mat kar, basically here. So that's basically, coming from a dad to a kid, right? I mean, that chinta mat kar, it's fine, don't worry about it. So I mean each language has that, but thought of like writing all of them. Now let's look at other forms of math. Okay. So I'll give you a couple of different, basically cases of math, and then you can tell me, your understanding of how to use prohibitive nipat, which is math. So I'll give you a quiz here. Don't talk to Don't talk to me. You write down this, translate the sentence into Hindi using the prohibitive form mat, and use different forms. You can be polite, you can be direct, you can be, giving order. So I'll give you like a minute or two to think about it, and then you can like go over it. Another thing is like, to talk is, you can use it as bolna, or in this case you can say baat karna. Baat karna, to talk. Because to bolna is kind of to speak, right? To talk is like when you're gossiping, it is like baat karna. Okay. Anyone else you want to? You can use different forms. That's completely fine. Okay. So a couple of things I noticed here, and that's probably how it is written in English. Don't talk to me. Basically, still, I'm trying to say is with me when you're talking to, you're trying to talk with someone, right? So it's, with me is mujhse. Mujhse. Okay, so there could be confusion here because like to sometimes is referred to as ko in Hindi, but it's basically in Hindi it's referring to like don't talk with me, I'm talking with someone, right? So mujhse baat mat karna, and you're telling someone don't talk, don't ever talk to me. Or you can, in that case, मुझसे कभी बात मत करना, don't ever talk to me. Okay? Or that's the first form, which is the, again, general form, right? Present indefinite. Or basically infinitive, not even indefinite, right? Infinitive, because the karna has not changed its form. Second one, as you are, we've been using it, मुझसे मत, मुझसे बात मत कीजिए, मुझसे बात मत कीजिए और मुझसे मत बात कीजिए, as I said, और मुझसे बात मत करो इन द फोर्थ वन, मुझसे बात मत कर। So I'll take a pause here to see if you have any questions, but you know, as I said, you can use different type of forms here, that's not a problem. Okay. Feel free to ask any questions you may have at this point before I, you know, before I, you know, jump to the next section. Okay. So I mean, I'm just like, for the sake of example, I picked some of the things which, you know, Mahatma Gandhi used to have, like, you know, he used to have three symbolical, you know, three monkeys, right? I mean, and then, you know, they will be three different kind of monkeys, like, you know, apes basically, and he'll make a point with them, right? I mean, such as like, don't do not see anything bad, or don't listen anything bad, or don't speak anything bad. Right, so I'm just going to use it as an exercise here. So, you know, don't see, let's say, bad. I'm just using the don't speak. I mean, I'm just using harmful words, and then don't hear anything bad, basically. So I'm just using one word. I mean, there can be a bona fide word here, but the generic word he is using here is bura. Bura is anything which is bad or ill or harmful. So you can use it as it is, bura, for all of them. So, okay, so now coming back to the question is like you have to translate all of these three things into like a Hindi sentences in a way that they rhyme together, and you use mat as well. And then there will be three verbs: to see, to speak, and to hear. And think of it as like you want to be respectful, but still want to give some, you know, basically semi-respectful, right? So you can use the third form, which is like, you know, where you say, you know, चलो, or you know, चिंता मत करो. You can use those kind of forms here. Okay, very good. What are the other sentences? Keep doing. Okay, so you started right, very right. I mean, or either you can say mat before, or you can, you know, use the word bura first. So what exactly it means, like the first is to see, so it's bura, and then mat, dekho. And then he'll say बुरा मत बोलो. And then the third one is don't hear that, like बुरा मत सुनो. Okay, it's pretty popular, you know, if you just Google like three monkeys of Mahatma Gandhi, those will appear, like, you know, three monkeys. And this is also symbolical, basically, that, you know, to kind of give instructions to the people, basically, on, you know, what to follow or something like that, right? So I hope this is clear. Any questions on math, you know, we can discuss now, or, you know, you can ask me any questions on math. As you said, like, you know, you can use Bura Mat Dekhiye, Bura Mat Boliye, and Bura Mat Suniye as well, if you want to be really respectful. You know, in this case, if you want to be semi-respectful, you can use them. So I hope this is clear. You know, the homework here is, like, you know, use math. You know, you pick up any word and you use them, and you at least send me 3-4 sentences using this, and I'll review it. Okay. The next one I'll take is basically a surprised form of, which is, like, also another interesting thing. The next one I'm going to take is, you know, surprised form, or, you know, surprise, or form which shows surprise. Okay. The keyword that you use for Nipat here is kya, or we'll also use kash. Kash is perhaps. So far, you know, kya we have heard is like what, right? And it's always used in the interrogative form when you're asking someone a question, such as aapka naam kya hai, what is your name? That is true, right? But imagine that, you know, you give me your name and I get really surprised or excited about it, and I say kya naam hai, right? Kya naam hai. Now it really depends on, you know, how I'm asking, you know, how I'm saying this thing. You know, it could also mean that what is your name, or it could also mean that, okay, what a name. What a name. Basically, I'm showing my excitement or surprise behind it, and I'm saying, oh, wow, what a name, okay? Or, you know, let's say I'm watching a game, right, a football game or cricket or anything, volleyball, baseball, and, you know, and if I, all of a sudden, out of surprise, if I say, kya game hai, it shows my surprise behind it, right? And, kya game hai, basically, the game is pretty close, or, you know, you are getting a thrill out of it. That's when you say kya game hai. Now again, like, you know, how you're saying it makes a difference. If you say yeh kya game hai, basically, you know, you may be asking a question, what game is this? You know, let's say when I watched this, like, you know, softball for the first time, you know, it could be a genuine question that, okay, what kind of game is this, right? In that case, you can say yeh kya game hai, right? However, if you're showing surprise and if you are into the game and you're saying kya, in a sense of surprise, you will say kya game hai, or kya baat hai. Kya baat hai. Kya baat hai is like when you're hearing a, you know, let's say somebody's talking, somebody's making sense, or if they said something very interesting, you can say kya baat hai. Like, you know, or you can say kya khana. Let's say you went to a restaurant and you liked it a lot. Kya khana hai? Right? I mean, you can say kya before the you know, the verb here, kya khana hai. I mean, this is slightly interesting way, right? I mean, one word, you khana acha hai. You can say that khana bahut acha hai. Like, that's a direct sentence. But if you want to bring some excitement and surprise in it, you can use kya, kya khana hai. Or let's say if I served you a chai, you know, by the way, I make very good chai, okay? So you can say kya chai hai. If you like it, you can say kya chai hai. Okay? Or kya coffee hai. So let's take a pause here. And I'm gonna give you a quiz, right? I'm not sure if you've seen the movie called Slumdog Millionaire. But the host, when Jamal, the player, you know, he is sitting on the desk when they're playing this game, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, right? I mean, the host keeps saying, what a player. What a player, right? How will you say that? You know, using your Nipat, surprise form of, you know, the Nipat, which is kya. How do you say What a player in Hindi. That's the question. Okay. Okay, very good, right? And you know, it's interesting, right? I mean, yeah, player hai. That's exactly right. And that's what the host keeps saying, like when the guy is, you know, winning, the host can't believe that the guy is from a very humble background and he knows all the questions, right? I mean, so that's when you use the surprise form of nipat using, you know, kya. I hope this is clear. I'll take another one, which is kash. So the next one is Kash. Kash is perhaps. Right? So you know, you can say perhaps, or you know, perhaps. Perhaps. He or she will come for the movie. Okay, so you're using perhaps here. You know, I'm going to give you know, a couple of minutes to see how you can use kash here. Simple sentence, but I want you to use kash in the sentence. For the movie. Okay. Let me make it simple. I'll add one more verb to watch the movie. I was looking for movie ke liye, but now I change it a little bit. And remember, the subject is he or she. Okay, very good, right? So you're saying काश वह, और यू कैन से वो मूवी देखने के लिए आएगा. I'm not sure if you can see it, so I'm going to write it again. So you're saying काश वो मूवी देखने के लिए आएगा फॉर अ गाय एंड देन आएगी फॉर अ गर्ल. ओके, यू कैन सी दैट यू नो टू वॉच वॉज देयर, सो इट वॉज सपोज टू बी देखना, बट बिकॉज यू हैव अ के लिए, यू नो योर देखना बिकम्स देखने, राइट? देखने के लिए आएगा और आएगी. इनिशियली आई वॉज लुकिंग फॉर जस्ट अ सिंपल वन, काश वो मूवी के लिए आएगा और काश वो मूवी के लिए आएगी, राइट? एज आई सेड, यू कैन यूज काश आफ्टर द सेंटेंस एज वेल. यू नो द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग इज लाइक दे डोंट चेंज, राइट? इट्स नॉट लाइक यू हैव मल्टीपल मूवीज और मेनी पीपल, काश बिकम्स, यू नो काश टेक्स अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म. नो, काश रिमेन्स काश, लाइक यू नो इट, दे डोंट चेंज द फॉर्म. Similarly, like you know, if there are many players, you know, you still say kya players hain or kya games hain. You don't, kya doesn't change the form. That's the beauty of, you know, nipat, or you know, the emphatical words. So what I'll do, folks who are watching live on YouTube, let's meet again next week. You know, next week we should be able to complete the entire topic. There are about four or five more forms of these sentences, these words, which we'll cover in the next class. For folks who are live on Google Hangout, we'll open it up for discussion. So thank you so much. I'll stop the broadcasting.